Xinxing 公主, the princess Xinxing, was Li Shimin's 15th daughter. No records about her biological mother. In 624, Zhenzhu Ke Han asked Li Shimin to marry him a Tang princess. Because Li Shimin's important military leader, Qi Li Hebi, was captured by Zhenzhu Ke Han, so Li Shimin decided to arrange Princess Xinxing to be married with Zhenzhu Ke Han to exchange Qi Li Hebi coming back to Tang. After Qi Li Hebi came back, he thought this political marriage would increase Zhenzhu Ke Han's power, so he tried his best to persuade Li Shimin to cancel this arrangement. Li Shimin accepted his advice and sent a messenger to chase the princess back. Then Li Shimin required Zhenzhu Ke Han personally pick up the princess in Lingzhou and must give Tang 100,000 livings as gifts. Zhenzhu Ke Han agreed. Unfortunately, on their way to Lingzhou, they met a snowstorm and half of livings died. Because Zhenzhu Ke Han couldn't get enough livings as gift, Li Shimin cancelled the marriage. Later, the princess Xinxing got married with Zhang Shunxi, who was from the Empress Zhang Shun's clan. Chengyang 公主, the princess Chengyang, was Li Shimin's 16th daughter. Because she was born by the Empress Zhang Shun, she could often see her father and become one of Li Shimin's favorite daughters. Princess Chengyang's first husband was Du He. Du He's father was Du Ruhui, who was one of 24 Lingyan Pavilion officers. In 643, the crown prince planned to rebel. Du He was an important supporter of the crown prince. Unfortunately, someone discovered their plan to Li Shimin. Du He was arrested and killed. After finishing the first marriage, Princess Chengyang was remarried with Xue Guan. This time, to make sure the princess could have a happy marriage, Li Shimin ordered a prophet to predict this marriage. In Tang Dynasty, the wedding ceremony was held in late afternoon. But according to the results of the prediction, Princess Chengyang's wedding should be held in the day. Li Shimin planned to follow the prediction, but eventually had to give up because of the disagreement of the government officer. In the second marriage, Princess Chengyang was really happy. She totally got birth 3 boys. After Li Shimin passed away, the Emperor Gao Zhong really cared about this 4 little sister. In 664, Princess Chengyang involved in Wu Gu An, which was a serious curse in ancient China. According to the laws of Tang, Princess Chengyang should be killed. But Gao Zhong didn't do it. He even didn't blame Princess Chengyang. The only punishment was Princess Chengyang's husband be demoted and should leave the capital to work as a local government officer. Because Princess Chengyang loved her husband very much, she insisted to accompany her husband. This serious case didn't affect the relationship between Gao Zhong and Princess Chengyang. In 681, Gao Zhong and Wu Zetian's only surviving daughter, the Princess Taiping, was married with the third son of Princess Chengyang. In 671, Princess Chengyang passed away in Fangzhou. Upon getting the news, Gao Zhong was extremely sad and officially mourned for 5 days. Thank you for watching this video. See you soon.